bitch better have my money.
Patrice's DVD is out today. Even if you saw the special over the weekend, it's 45 more minutes of material.
Yeah, man. It's the segues that make the jokes make sense. After I come from a commercial and now I'm talking about animals.
Yeah, yeah.
I was talking about titties and it's one before. So
the segue is very important. And also, worth the price of admission is you railing on that bitch in the audience.
Oh, you had the DVD.
Yeah.
You watched the whole DVD.
Yeah.
How was that? I didn't see the whole.
It's fucking great. It is fucking great.
You saw the whole and fucking that, thing.
Yeah.
Yeah, I was worried they wouldn't have the you going after that girl.
That's on a DVD.
That was a long bit.
It
couldn't be part of the special because it was too
brutally
long.
Funny. Like, it's brutal, but it's so funny. And you get the boyfriend or the guy that she ain't fucking, whatever he is, you get him to completely take your side.
Do you understand that he tweeted me?
You did.
That guy, and said...
Thank you.
He said, dude, you're right about that girl.
You're absolutely right. You have a knack of looking at people in an audience because you're doing your act. I don't think people think you're paying attention to them. So when you're looking at them and you call someone out, you fucking bam, 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 and let everyone know what they're all about in one sentence.
But do you know that because it's the difference between... TV, because you get a lot of people that come to a comedy show and think they're watching Comedy Central.
Yeah,
like you go, like in Houston, this little fucking douchey little white kid with his family was just being like, whatever. I go, you know what's weird, man? I mean, not that I'm threatening you, but you just have, there's nothing in you that says I'm a fucking big black dude that could slap this shit out of you.
Yeah, what the fuck?
Like, something fucked you up.
There's not a wall up here, dude.
I'm not threatening you, kid. Yeah, I'm just saying, you gotta understand, here's how close I could be to you, and you're being disrespectful.
And you don't know.
Because you can turn from me.
Yeah.
You know, so I like doing crowd stuff, but when I was doing it, that girl, her face was anti-laughing.
Oh, yes.
I said, I'm not being this unfunny. I said, you're just being a little cunt.
Yeah. Oh, it was classic.
It was great.
I'm glad you saw the DVD. Yeah. So I'm glad you saw the DVD because it's like, because there's one part that I wanted to be in the show desperately, but it was just talking about guys not caring about their woman's health. It's just
that was really funny.
I wanted that to be on the special on TV
great.
So bad.
Yeah.
Just talking about how you've never had your man go, When's your fucking your pussy doctor appointment?
Your pussy doctor.
Sweetie, when is your pussy doctor appointment? Have you checked your breasts for lumps lately? Never, ever have we ever gave a fuck about a woman's health.
It's on the DVD.
And it ain't like you don't give a fuck. You just, you just go, oh shit, I never asked my girl.
I don't think about it.
My girl goes to the doctor, she says, I got a doctor's appointment. I'm like, well, good luck.
Okay. Not what is it for? What doctor? What do you need? What do you got? Is it the checkup? Is it nothing? Oh, okay. That's it.
You've been taking care of yourself?
If you said, yeah, I'm going to the doctor, what sweetie? What do you what doctor? What?
There you go. Let's break. So you get the DVD and all the regular places.
Oh, yeah.
So Patrice's DVD is out today. Elephant in the Room.
Yes.
More with Patrice, and I think Kurt Metzger is stopping by today to
Kurt
say hi.
Kurt Metzger.
He's here? All right, he'll join the show next. Stay there. Of course, we got Big Mama Prods, Patrice O'Neal in studio. His DVD's out today. Make sure you check that out. Elephant in the Room. Most of us saw it on Comedy Central on Saturday night, but there's 45 minutes of material you have not seen. And some just unbelievable stuff on the DVD. Stuff that should have made the special, but because of time restraints and all sorts of shit. So make sure you pick up the DVD today. Also, Kurt Metzger in studio.
Metzger.
Patrice is telling us all about you during the break.
What'd he say?
Saying you got a big hog, and he's also saying you got a good clit joke.
But Kurt is fucking, he's in the next echelon of the young gangsters coming up.
Yeah, really?
Pushing the old fellas out.
Yeah. I should get more work then.
He's a fucking weirdo. He's a natural weirdo. That's his problem.
It's like a real weirdo?
He's a big, 8-foot tall, strange man.
Yeah,
Patrice makes me nervous sometimes.
Why?
Patrice
made me nervous for years, to be completely honest with you.
Really?
Yeah. Well, I brought...
You never knew that? You're intense.
Yeah.
What?
I swear to God. Well, it's been a while. It's been a bunch of years now.
I take care of Kurt. I always tell Kurt.
I'm a big fan of Patrice. I'm just like...
Kurt's a fucking beast.
I turned into a weirdo next to him.
I was intimidated by Patrice probably the first 3 years you did this show.
Really?
Oh, yeah. I don't know what it was.
Dude, that's special.
Are you just lovable, Patrice?
Elf in the room, my girl that you pissed off at the barbecue because you told her dress was inappropriate or something.
That's what I'm talking about.
She was dressed like a whore, like I love it. You told her she hated it. She hated Patrice like ever since then. She made us watch it twice in a row.
Really?
Elf in the room. Yeah.
How bad was the dress?
It was like
American Apparel horse shit that all girls wear. It wasn't like
How can you be with a comic and not have a sense of humor?
Yeah.
Like I tell my girl to calm down if people fuck with you because you know.
Yeah, but it's not. She's got like she had to wear like a back brace or something in high school, you know. So she's like, she's got like this weird complex that she's being made fun, you know.
I have a fucked up way of like picking out exactly what's gonna make somebody really horrible.
It was really amazing. Like, why are you so mad right now? He just hit her like right in the.
Well, but
right
he always goes for the one thing. He knows.
But I didn't
Patrice
know that. Scoliosis.
You felt it.
I just didn't
you
know. I didn't know the motherfucking his damn girl had fucking bad backs.
I just took it like he thought she was hot and like trying to knock her down a peg,
yeah.
Which I love that he does with hot chicks because I'm racist against hot chicks in general. And he would really, I mean, it's really great just bring a girl around to him and have him go to town on it.
Just have her get smashed.
Yeah, she was already knocked down a peg from life before she got.
I'll tell you why Kurt's good though. Kurt, I don't know why it isn't what happened. Kurt was starting to get his own thing going. That's what happened because I'd bring Kurt on the road a couple of times.
Mm-hmm.
But I would find myself, I go, Kurt's good because I would find myself watching and being into his act all the way to the end, and I got to go on after him.
Oh,
so
shit.
I had to go get into character. I'd be like, shit, I got to get into character. But he'd be saying some shit. And one of the jokes, I don't do it justice. I don't want to be corny, but
that was about the African story. That's what we're talking about, the clit thing.
Yeah, could you just say that? It made me laugh so hard. I'm putting pressure on him to be funny with this shit.
We'll acknowledge that there's some pressure.
Yeah, what is that?
The thing he likes is the end of it, because I used to live above African Store in Brooklyn. It was like a real place, and there was a sign that would say African Supplies on the. On the store, that used to creep the hell out of me.
Yeah, what are those?
Yeah, what the hell? That can't be good, right? You're like, all right, I need a machete with bloody hair on it. I need an army uniform for a 5-year-old. I need a sharp rock to circumcise my daughter. And then everybody gets mad. I'm like, listen, I'm not pro female circumcision unless you have like one of the giant clits that I hate. It's like a small dick. Then just like. You know, don't use a rock. Just a little off the top and get like that petty paw.
That petty paw.
And just. If you want to see Davies.
Just work it down petty
so you look
petty,
like a human and not some kind of a.
A giant clit looks just like a fucking animal's. An animal's claw that's too
long.
Oh
my God, dude. I was with this Puerto Rican girl one time and she was hot too, but she had her clit. I mean, I looked at it, dude. It looked like a miniature dick. Like,
oh,
it's like a miniature, it had
God.
A little. Jim, mushroom head,
like
on.
A head on it.
Jimmy's all. He's not here to defend himself, but he would agree.
He loves that.
He is
he
into
that.
That and me and Anna,
giant clits are sexy, man.
No, me and Anna. No, the ones he likes, we just never understood over the years.
The little baby penises.
He likes
looks like
the little penis.
Mini dicks.
Yeah, his own mini poke. Dick. Yeah, it looks like he's looking back at himself.
There it is.
The like pink Norton head. Of a,
it's the dew claw.
Yeah,
it's the dew claw.
She had a clit like a
dew claw.
She had a clit like a dew claw. That's it.
I thought you were talking about that.
There's a million comics going to go out tonight to try to get their fucking rights to dew claw.
The dew claw.
What the fuck is that claw used for anymore?
That's like that.
Holding cigarettes back when they were.
I'll tell you exactly what that claw is used for. When you put rubber bands around his snout, he uses that to take the shit off.
Oh, man.
It's his thumb.
Yeah, it's like his thumb.
What's that mess above that called?
That's that pad thing. That's the band of dogs.
What is that used for?
It's the foot pads, man. You know.
No, that.
I know.
It's their natural shoes.
It's called the labia majora.
That's way up on
the dew claw.
It probably has something to do with fucking when they were ripping apart a caveman's throat. It was easier to fucking
to hold on.
Yeah, it was padded.
Hey Kurt, who's the
slip on blood?
Who's the top five now? Who's the young soldiers now? They got Hannibal. Who else?
Who's your crew?
I'm only Turks.
No, not the crew, but
why not the crew?
There's
definitely
no
Hannibal's
crew no more,
in the top
but
five.
You sort of had your.
I don't. I was.
You had your guys.
Yeah, there was a tough crowd crew.
But who's his circle?
There's no circles.
No more circles.
It's what Comedy Central The scene.
Oh, the hot list. You mean?
Yeah. Who's in the scene?
Well,
who's
it was the real hot list, not a made up list.
Reggie Watts and the people.
Is Reggie Watts in New York?
I don't know. He's always, if he is, he's always doing.
I've
a room
never met him,
go
and it's like fucking. I watched him, and I, you know.
I like him because he looks like a Where the Wild Things Are creature.
I hear about him. Somebody's like, oh, Reggie Watts. But he's like a beatboxer and a DJ or something.
Yeah, it's not it's not like stand up. It's like
I hate how unfunny you can be and still be in the comedy game.
Yeah, yeah.
And I'm not saying Reggie Watts is unfunny.
Right. No,
this thing where there's a comfort zone that some of these young comics have. I'm watching some of the new. I keep up with who's out there. I do. You have to. I'm watching all the new Comedy Central specials,
yeah.
And it's just these young guys, you know, with long, unpronounceable names, and they're just comfortable.
Yeah.
Like,
yeah,
they're comfy. They do well, and
yeah, they all in the same rhythms, dude, in those rooms, and then they just talk that way.
I'm gonna not put pressure on myself because this is supposed to be funny. If you laugh,
I don't want to reek of effort right now.
No.
You know, it was a big thing back in like the 80s and early 90s.
Yeah.
That you don't see anymore, that I didn't think ever fit into comedians, is the team, the two guys that would get up there and do a team.
Oh, people still do that all the time, man.
I haven't seen
two guys that combined are half as funny as one guy. It's amazing.
Oh, well, yeah. I think they're the brothers.
The Scalabros might be the last. Team, but they're twin brothers, so you can't really.
It's like the it worked with the Smothers Brothers back in the 60s when everyone was laughing at anything.
And Paul Mooney's kids are the Mooney twins.
Really? They do
something? Like Smothers Brothers had like Paul one Mooney's guy was dumb. And now people just finish each other's sentences. Like,
yeah, is that what the thing is now?
I just don't enjoy this new I don't have to be funny thing.
Yeah,
just
they prefer
irony,
if you're not.
But it's not irony. It's just
I just did a show,
and you don't get it. You didn't laugh because you didn't get it.
No, I'll tell you what it is, dude. It's the one. That whole scene of alternative is controlled by chicks. These awful chicks that look like Carmen Sandiego with like glasses and wig haircuts.
Thank you.
And they control that scene.
By the
way,
why Kurt's having a bad time? Because Kurt is he. That's what he'll say. This people don't understand. That's how you don't get in. Is you trash who trash.
And you take them back to high school. Like I was always a nerd. I'm like a jock when I go to those rooms. I'm like, oh god, this like a rapist slash bear to them. Just because I'm not doing complete bullshit. I mean complete bullshit.
Because they're smart enough. Here's the thing. They're smart enough to do material that they know is interesting, but they know it's like a woman doing edgy shit, but it's not really, they're not really edgy.
You're right.
They know that edgy's, it's just like anything else they do that they challenge men. They play basketball and it stinks, but they know that they're going to getting credit because they're girls.
Right.
So you if you're sort of funny as a girl, you'll get credit. But these girls, they come on with this. The hottest comic I've ever seen. It's like you go, first of all, like, what's her name? Schlesinger? She's so sexy.
I couldn't tell you one of your jokes.
Why are you funny? When did you need to be funny? Yeah. This bitch is gorgeous.
She should have to wear a burka on stage, dude.
Biggest natural titties you've ever fucking seen.
What's her name, Travis?
Elijah Schlesinger.
Eliza Schlesinger.
You can't even resent her if she like bumps you on a show or something.
I like what you just said. When did you need to be funny? Because you guys all had some horrible thing that happened to you in your lives.
It's rare you
made
get a,
you need to be funny.
It's rare you get a really good looking.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, but this picture is not even doing a joke.
It's not.
No, that's
and she wears
pretty
tight
nice right
shit
there.
Too.
Yeah, she's like hot.
She's funny.
That's pretty nice right there.
I don't think I've ever seen her.
Oh, dude, last time like standing, she went on you, and the camera would like pan.
Look at this fucking girl.
God.
It's a comic.
Get the fuck out of here.
Yeah,
she sits
why
in this
she
room,
decide to be
and
a
it's
comic?
Like, really, am I going to... Really, sweetie, you know how funny you got to be? As funny as I have to be at a Klan meeting. Like, hold on, guys. Hold on. No, seriously. I'm a funny motherfucker. Wait a minute.
No, put that shit down. I'm really funny.
Any clips?
There you go. That's how she does her comedy?
With her belly.
With the hip bones
sticking out? Badge is like almost showing.
Yeah, has some good vag showcasing dresses she wears.
Damn.
I could never get past the deaf broad. Like, I'm like, you're not as funny as that awful.
That's terrible.
What about the time? Knock, knock, knock.
Bitch. That deaf girl episode on Seinfeld when she goes, when he's like, what are you, deaf or something? She goes, bingo. It's like, oh, shuck.
Didn't she get run over on the beach?
Fuck.
Who?
I think we laughed for days over her.
Who, this chick?
No, the deaf comic.
The deaf comic.
I think she got hit by a fucking beach patrol fucking guy. Yeah.
Dude,
this goes back about 3 or 4 years. We laughed for weeks.
She was big in the scene, too. But there was another one, a dude.
Twitter, help me out today. What's her name?
A Spanish guy that was in a wheelchair, dude, who has cerebral palsy that used to force you to have to listen to him.
Yeah, I hate that.
I hate that. I know who that is.
He was famous. He did the rounds.
Yeah, I know who you're talking
about. There is some shit you're just not cut out for. Like, obviously, I'm not going to be a football player. It just isn't going to happen. Physically, it just doesn't work out.
So
some of these comics should not be comics.
Right.
Because you're instantly taking away the funny when you're reminding everybody of their mortality.
Well, Josh was working hard, and he...
He was all right. I mean,
so he told me they thought he was faking the palsy to do extra blood on the Kaiser Soze. Julian McCarthy. <Kaiser Soze. laughs> At the end of the contest, he walked away all normal.
We can't find the comic, the deaf comic. What are we trying?
Verbal.
Eliza, we're trying to see. You asked if she was funny. I never really. I seen her tits and I turned. Like, I just go, she could be funny, but I just go,
pop that up.
I've never heard a word.
A good fight. We're into it. It's in our blood.
She
that's why
big
the fighting
tits.
Irish of Notre Dame, not the negotiating Jews of Brandeis.
What? I didn't hear that.
I didn't hear it.
She turned sideways.
Hold on.
And her ass was fucking beautiful.
So beautiful, dude.
Here we go.
Is she good? I saw
her. Hold on. Here we go. One person in this room, redo that joke.
What?
What did she just say?
I don't know.
We got four guys. One guy.
I knew the point.
Yeah, I know the point.
I know the point. I got it.
But I was staring at her titties and her ass.
You couldn't recite that joke.
I got it. You know what?
Give me the punchline.
I skimmed it.
The punchline is the punchline is
the actual punchline, not the overall punchline you just got.
I can't get the wrong
one. That's my point.
Happy 4th of July.
I heard happy 4th of July.
And we didn't win this country in a Yahtzee.
I heard
Yahtzee.
Those are the two things I
picked up. My
on.
Fucking protruding nipples.
Oh, what if she took
you want
a dew claw, dude?
Yeah. Be... A dew claw clip.
If she has a dew claw, I don't care.
Why do girls have dignity? If I was her, do you know how many balls would just be in my fucking mouth? Executive balls?
Executive balls.
You're so fucking right.
Why? No one's interested in my horrifying nothing balls.
Maybe that was different.
You think I wouldn't let if some fucking horrid woman executive wanted to just take a swipe of my balls for a special?
Yeah.
Why
you'd
not?
Do that, right?
I think I'm funny.
Fuck dignity.
You know how amazing my pussy is? That's what I would just be saying all day long.
Look at how funny my tit is.
Why am I working? Why am I trying to work and make something?
I would just make sure my tits look good every day.
Yeah. Pop up another one. Maybe
so right. All right, try to focus.
Get like doggy style. That sounds a little blue.
All right, yeah. Maybe we can focus on a sex bit.
But why'd you put up official? You got to get YouTube where it's she has see Comedy Central.
No, but we're right here.
I know, but Comedy Central is not fair to anybody's funniness.
All right, that's fair
that's
enough.
True.
It's because
but we don't even know what she's saying because we're distracted by what she
looks
like.
That's because of the lighting.
She's at the Laugh Factory.
Let's do hand job at the Laugh Factory.
There you go.
All right.
At the Laugh Factory. Ideal date.
All right, good
the
point. Laugh Factory.
Now we're talking.
You know?
But, like, seriously, like, just, I don't have, like, a ton of sex. I'm going to put that out there because we're, like, BFF right now. But, like, you don't, hand job, you don't, as it happens, as adults, it's pretty much you make out, and you rub a little bit, and then you have sex, or you can beat or something. I mean, you can't do a hand job. If you pull out a hand job, you'd be like, what are you doing? This tickles me, stop. It's so uncomfortable. You don't do hand jobs, right? And this guy was like, I was like, I don't want to hook up. I'm like, I had to go or something. He's like, come on. He's like, what about just a hand job? And I was like, I'll tell you what, fucker. I'll give you a hand job. But it's got to be on my terms. It's 45 minutes long. No lotion.
and you don't break eye contact.
That's just like more sexy.
And then right when
talk.
I know.
You're the best. If you're annoyed, turn it on. I never talk about this.
Look at her
this is great.
Ass,
turn
dude.
It on him.
Yes.
Like as it's about to go. Don't,
she
like,
might be the hottest comic I've ever seen.
Yeah. It goes back at him.
She's
can I tell you this?
Really.
I had a boyfriend, and now that I'm looking back at the story, there's a reason I don't have one anymore. When you get the goo
what do you think
on your
problem
hand.
Is?
Because like
what do you
he's
mean?
Right at that stage.
Every comic
like,
has a problem.
Like, just like he's here, just go.
Well, what happens? You done?
Yeah, we can
they
turn.
Get very upset.
What do you think? What do you think her problem is?
Life has been too easy.
Ah, she's gotten
these
everything
comics,
based
this
on
this bitch
love.
Should be have scars on her soul. let me tell you who's funny. Ruth Buzzy. Because she came up with Don Rickles calling her a fucking ugly cunt. Lucia Ball, Gilda Radner, fucking
Phyllis Diller.
Phyllis fucking Diller.
Oh, she's fun. Man.
Joan fucking Rivers. Who, you know,
ugly broad.
Ugly
and,
bitches.
And who's the other one? The one that did all the Lily Tomlin.
Oh,
these
yeah.
girls, see, it'll get back to her that we was fucking with a little bit, right? Wasn't really trashing her.
No, we're not trashing
no,
her.
No, we're not
trashing her. But I'm saying, it'll, she'll take it as a trash.
How hot she is.
But it's like these women don't
we'll
go through shit because women run shit.
Right.
They don't come up through the fucking rank and file of horror.
Dude, Amy Schumer, hot and funny.
Another easy. Amy Schumer tells people don't. She's on stage. I heard stories. Or say to guys, you know, don't bring me up like that. Or bitch, shut the fuck up. You know what? I'm trying to finger pop you before you come on stage. Fucking country hoe. Just get on stage. Like you they don't go through nothing.
Shit.
This comfortable bitch talking about yakking niggas off at the beach, like with giant tits.
Oh,
fuck out of here, man. You're supposed to go through war.
Yeah, there's supposed to be a lot more hurt, I think.
I think, you know what, I think Amy's funny, though, because she's not as hot as, like, probably she wanted to be, so she's got that going.
Yeah,
I think
she's
funny, though, honestly.
Yeah.
But she has Sarah Palin disease because she's a comic. People, she's hot for.
Yeah.
Oh, hot for.
Oh, right.
She's, you know what I mean?
And what's Sarah Palin disease
hot
exactly?
Hot for.
It's like... People go, woo, Sarah Palin, but she's hot because all the other politician bitches
right.
are horrendous.
But she's like the only hot chick in Alaska, too. That's what
she's
hot.
Chick
in Alaska.
She's hot for reasons. And Amy's a cutie pie, whatever, but I'm saying it's too easy. It's too easy.
We're going to move back to the deaf comic, Kathy Buckley.
No! I remember on Arsenio, she brought like a machine that says, "This helps me hear." And she's doing a fucking act. You know, what you mean?
About a hearing aid?
And you have to have. She's not funnier than her deafness.
Yes. Can we get a Kathy.
She looks deaf.
Look at her face. And was she the one run over by the beach because she can hear the fucking
know.
Guy beeping the horn?
I think it is.
I think it is. I think we laughed for
who's
days over that.
Who's a funny handicapped comic? Do you know any?
No.
It's too
distracting. Well, they have to be not... It has to be a certain handicap.
Rich Voss.
Funniest dwarf out there. He's got emphysema in his
Voss, he has a disease
he's
that
got a
you
lung
can't...
bubble and he's...
it's distracting.
Okay.
If you're in a wheelchair but you're regular, fine. If you have a physical handicap...
Well, who's a wheelchair guy that we laugh at?
None now. I can't think any.
No.
There's really none.
Has there ever?
Well,
but he had a. It's almost like Josh Blue.
How did they get on stage? Like, if you're a wheelchair, I've never seen access.
There was a guy in Boston.
No, a fucking ramp.
We had to lift him up.
Oh shit!
His
really?
Name was Matt. Something in Boston. I stopped lifting him up.
Matt. That's funny. A guy that can't stand up named Matt.
When stand up sat out.
And he got heavier. Like, he wouldn't even try to pretend to be lighter when we would lift him on stage. He would almost sink down harder to
fucked.
Have us have trouble right. getting him on. I said, I'm not lifting you on stage
he
anymore. You fucking
his legs
dead.
Up even more somehow.
Yeah, you piece of shit.
He's purposely eating unhealthy.
Yeah, fuck you.
Couldn't go on a diet, so it was easier for you guys. Fuck
but
it.
Cerebral
fuck
palsy is very difficult.
Josh Blue, I think, is kind of funny.
What?
I can't.
I thought he was funny.
I can't get past the distraction.
Yeah,
of,
I can't get past.
And when I went to that,
that's all I'm noticing.
I can't.
All right, let's get
could
some
be the
Kathy
funniest
Buckley.
Shit ever.
And was Kathy Buckley the one
she
run
was,
over?
She was the one that was run over.
You're not gonna be able to move on from life until you find this
no,
bitch
because,
guy.
No, I'll tell you why.
Patrol.
We laughed for days, and I wasn't sure if it was the comic or someone else that was deaf because
deaf.
Huh?
Go back.
To her being deaf.
And there's a bit called being deaf. When they talk about their handicap.
Caroline.
It's the best. It's the best part.
Oh, that awful deaf lady's haircut.
Yes, it's true. I am hearing impaired. No, I am not deaf.
Pause. I can't. And she's got goofy eyes on top.
She looks all goofy.
She's got goofy eyes.
And comfort. This is, listen. If she just got a smashing every day from comics, she would be funny.
Yeah.
Like,
yeah.
But she's, you see her comfortable.
She's strutting around
but
on
that's
the stage.
Why, by the way, all those alternative fan comics, why not? They want to not ever be mocked ever.
Yeah,
they want to
form
their own clique and mock up. And like, if you can't take a hit, how can you ever be funny like that?
Yeah.
And when you're deaf, you think you'd be the ultimate funniest from that. Just that voice she has.
Yeah.
Man,
be hilarious.
You're my baby, Ben.
And that bad fucking mullet she's got.
Dumb mullet and that teacher's uniform. And nobody trashes her.
How is no one trashing her?
Nobody says, when you get the fuck up, get it.
She's opening her eyes twice as wide to make up for the loss of hearing. She's trying to increase the sense of sight.
When she gets done with
she's
that
trying to see sound.
She's opening her eyes wide to open up her ear canals.
Yeah. Oh, she's going to put a card down and ask for money after the fucking act.
Yeah,
we used to trash this stuttering comic in Boston so bad. I can't remember how to say his name, but we used to tease him unmercifully. He's hilarious, and he came in dressed really nice one day to Nick's, and we was like, "What the fuck you doing, man? Why y'all dressed nice?" He's like, "You go, what was you selling vacuums, right?" And then motherfucker goes, "No, motherfucker, I don't want no vacuum." You have to torture. It's brutality. It's pressure. It's trial by fire. It's destruction. And whoever comes out is the winner. You just come out.
Oh, that is great.
Can we go back to this?
Fuck.
I got to hear.
I have a feeling this clip's going to take a long
time. Rewind this.
It started with goofy eyes, man.
When rewind it and look how comfortably she just kind of flows in because she know no one's going to throw something at her fucking head.
And she looks like a dude.
She really has a dykey look to her, doesn't she?
She looks like a guy that went through a sex change a little too late in life.
Oh, boy.
Okay. Oh my God! Okay. Oh, I was just
been Glover.
I was
saying,
okay.
Is it one of these?
Oh yeah.
But she couldn't hear that, so that doesn't matter.
Okay.
Four wheeler hitting her on the beach.
Word coming in that do you know a comedian named Nikki Payne? She's
who is that?
Comic with a cleft palate.
No.
So after the Zephy, we gotta go to the cleft palate comic.
We'll take other suggestions on our Twitter right now.
You know what? And how different do you think it's gonna sound than in the deaf comic?
N-I-K-K-I.
It's a very similar handicap speech.
Yeah.
Wise.
All right, let's go with the
P-A-Y-N-E.
Here we go. Talking about her deafness.
Yes, it's true. I am hearing impaired. No, I am not deaf. I just don't listen.
Oh.
I just bought me one of those clappers. You know, when you clap your hands and your appliances go on and off. There's nothing more depressing than knowing that your appliances can hear better than you.
She sucks dick, man. I'm not gonna stand for that shit. Go to Nikki Payne, nigga.
No.
So bad.
We gotta keep going.
Wait, and it's
we
mixed with 80s horseshit.
Yeah.
Like,
yeah.
It's 80s all the way
the
through
clapper.
And through.
Stop it.
Oh, my God.
What are you gonna do, a falling and I can't get up joke?
Come on, we can't do a minute?
We're
15 seconds in. We're 15 seconds in
already, man.
Oh, believe
me. Let's give her a chance.
I'm trying to have fame, call. Do you understand? I'm waiting for fame to give me a call.
Yes.
You niggas is making me listen to this bitch.
It's a minute bit.
Jelly Jewel marathon, too, you motherfuckers.
We're 23 seconds in.
Oh, my God.
It's a little over a minute. Let's go. Let's try to get to the end.
Good.
One hour is negative, and then a couple years later, I developed spinal meningitis. That's just told my family, quote, that I would be a slow learner, and that I would not grow to be any taller than 5'2". And I was in a school for retardation for 2 years before they found out it was just a hearing loss.
And they caught me slow.
Oh, my God.
And then look at the clap she's getting for that.
Oh. So she can see him.
What the fuck?
Imagine you're waiting to go on, though, through this.
This is...
The comic is next. I'll listen to this.
Yeah.
We're almost at the end.
This is so bad. If a comic came up and did this and didn't have a handicap,
I don't know if it's low blood sugar,
it would be thrown out.
To have fame call me, you niggas is playing this bitch.
You're shaking over there.
What are you doing, man? I'm trying to fucking make it.
Are you that pissed or you need orange juice? I can't figure it out.
What is wrong with you, motherfucker?
This is infuriating.
We're almost there, though. We're almost there.
She didn't deserve to be on that stage.
I do wear two hand aids, one in each ear. I'd wear a third one if I knew where to put the darn thing. This is my brand new hearing aid. Get a load of this. It's computerized now. I have the hearing aids in my ears, and this is my remote control.
A remote control?
I am now in control of your laughter. Yeah. This baby cost me $4,000. $4,000, and I'm thinking for another $1,000, I could have had that boob job. Not like I'm gonna hear through my chest.
Is that TV?
Yeah, this
was TV. Comedy hour,
when it was,
right?
That was TV.
How did it take me so long to work that club, dude?
Yeah, see?
For years, I couldn't get
you should have just
nigga, cut your ears off. Stab your eyeballs out. You'll be fucking on in a minute.
Never mind. Yes, I like the booking gang. In the back, I'm a deaf to be okay tonight. Fine, I'll be.
Hey. Yeah, instead of like.
Yeah, hi, I'm a working comic. I've been like, click, hello? What? Hello? Have a hangnail.
If you were the deaf comic, how would you approach it, or would you just not do stand up, or would you? How'd you?
They just don't do.
You have to address it, right?
So, because they have to address it.
They have to.
It makes everyone so uncomfortable.
Everyone's like, "What the fuck is wrong?"
Everybody up until 2000 did comedy because they thought they were funny,
right?
So she did comedy to put a message out there.
Yeah,
that it's okay to
deaf
be deaf.
People can
it's a
do
message.
It too.
It's like,
no, they can't.
It's like if you were, if you did comedy as a deaf guy, you was a funny motherfucker. You figured it out.
Yeah.
Because people tease the shit out of you. And you learn how to be fucking funny. You're not funny unless somebody fucks with you.
Mm-hmm.
Can we get the other comic up?
I don't like equal footing. Even though I'm deaf, I'm a comic too. We're on equal footing. No, you're not.
We got Nick. Which bit you want? We need a short one, obviously. Nikki Payne, right?
Does she talk about her?
What's her problem again?
She got a cleft palate, but I like the old hair lip.
Yeah.
You know, and they meant it H-A-R-E
right,
as a rabbit
like a
mouth.
Yeah.
Looks like a little rabbit mouth. I always thought like a hair. What?
No.
A hair was grown out of there? And
that's
they left
what I did
the
too.
Scar
it's
like
a
that
rabbit
to
lip.
Remove it?
You got one?
Yeah.
Wait.
It's like, wow, that was a big hair.
A Beauty and the Beast lip.
Yes.
Is that it? Well, yeah, this should work.
Okay. All right.
We don't want to spend 5 minutes for this shit.
Oh, come on.
Let's just laugh for 30 seconds and move on.
Here for Nikki Payne, Nikki.
Oh, this is from Last Comic?
Oh, Last Comic.
She was on Last Comic.
We used to have to go to speech therapy for it. So every day the speech therapist would take me out of class.
She's Voss on helium.
Words over and over.
I'm out too. I'm out.
Wow.
Suck my dick, man.
She probably barely has a list thing happening.
Cartoon voiceover work, dude. She'd be all
out. Yeah, she could do that. She should just go right to Nickelodeon and say.
She doesn't speak that
like
bad.
A murder face. Murder face from Metalocalypse.
She's making it worse than it is.
You see that guy?
Yeah. Put that 9 minute one on. See what she's talking about.
Put that 9 minute one. Go ahead. Let me see this shit.
Put that 9 minute.
This is where we're going tonight, folks.
She's gonna tear the stitches up talking alone.
Not exactly intellectual comedy. Whole lot of f***ing humping.
All right. Yeah.
She's got the crowd going.
Right, miss.
This is CTV. I don't know. It's gonna be a whole lot of.
Oh, God. You know she must have taken some shit growing up, though, right?
I think she might be funny. Hold on.
I'm sorry. I've been only up here 2 seconds, and I've said about a million times. I'd like to tell you that I have Tourette's syndrome, but I don't. I just f***ing dirty. But that's an affliction I would love to have. I would love to have Tourette's syndrome, because if I did, I'd just march around town all day long going, f*** you!
That guy.
She's aware that she's a horror show. I think she's not. She's an eye just chick.
She knows she's a
last
nightmare.
Last time I stared at them, because she had to do that whole, I have speech impediment. You know, if I did last time, I had to go on and go, I'm overweight, and she's being overweight. It's like, you know. So she's aware. She's like not trying to, you know, she's just a mess.
Anyone? I'm really overweight and I sweat a lot. If I didn't, I would explode. Yeah. My father beat me with a whiskey bottle and I turned tragedy into comedy. Oh, did you? How about the comedy part?
Who's that?
Yeah, who are you?
Louis Anderson.
Fucking Louis Anderson.
Oh,
when he's
shit.
Like,
Oh, shit. I thought it was Roseanne for me.
Well, that too. Could be any of the above. Tragedy.
But Louis was a beast, though, back in the days, man.
Oh, God, but...
You didn't think he was unfunny until later.
I was not never, Family Feud.
I was never a fan of Louis Anderson. I think the first couple of times I saw him, I was like, all right, this is funny.
But he came out with Sam Kinison in them. They all came out together.
But then he started, like, getting on this whole thing of how... getting into his life and how he was beaten and... As a child, and
well, he's
it's like,
gay,
oh,
right? And
fun.
He couldn't say it.
Yeah,
that's a huge thing. Dude.
That's pretty much it.
Just a gay chunky people? Gay man.
Yeah. And then I think the Inquirer had some shit that he had got a bunch of boys over
the
his
pool
hotel.
Boy or something.
Yeah, yeah, he was paying
he
off some shit.
On.
That was the end. Oh, yeah, that was the end of it. I like sucking a cock.
Hey, they want to watch. We should acknowledge Sean Rouse. He's hilarious, and he's a mess on stage with that arthritis
like,
of his.
Yeah,
who?
He's got like three
Sean
things.
Rouse.
Really?
He's
wrong.
Fucking hilarious.
Yeah, he's a fight dude.
And he's got the bad arthritis, and he's supposed to not drink, but he fucking loves his drinking, which makes it worse.
Never heard of him.
His fingers are all just like fucking in weird directions and stuff. You never heard of Sean Rouse?
He'd open for a telethon.
Find Sean. Yeah. Is this a short clip? Yeah. Sean Rouse is.
Fuck him. That doesn't count.
Yeah.
That's.
No, he's a funny guy.
No, he's got a bunch of shit around him.
No,
really
he's funny, but arthritis just doesn't count.
It's like crippling. Count. Like his arms are like.
Oh, but, is he like this on stage?
If you flip her up a little bit, that doesn't even.
Flip her up a little bit.
Oh my God.
Because he's normal.
But he takes a medication.
He's got something else wrong with him, too.
No,
mentally?
I don't know.
No, the doctors basically say if you don't drink, it won't be as bad.
He's got bad white people breathing, unfortunately.
Huh?
It's like a, you know, like southern, like bad white people means too much of
them. Inbreeding.
I'm not putting him with Kathy Buckley.
No.
That's a hard one.
That's terrible audio there.
He's got a great joke on having sex with an underage girl, talking to the judge, which is just phenomenal.
He sounds funny. Sean Rouse is
really
and
funny.
And he's authentically miserable. Like
yeah,
he
has that
he looks
real
like
face.
Really...
Some guys are trying to pretend.
He was part of Jim Norton's thing there.
That's what it said?
Yeah. Oh, he said it. I'm sorry.
But arthritis doesn't... you're debilitated, but I got a pinched nerve in my neck that really fucking makes my arms hurt, so I'm not fucking going for it.
Like, he's not going to get up
and
on stage and you're going to be...
And I'm fucking diabetic. I have diabetes. Yeah. So it's like, no, you don't get...
But if you're like all like this, that doesn't...
Nah,
it's not
going to
distract you from the guy.
If you ever see a commercial, the old lady who's got arthritis, and she's like, I'm here to talk. And she's got these rubbery little hands.
Oh,
she holds
up.
Like, I'm
the
here to tell you.
The knuckles are going. She's like...
She's got
Tyrannosaurus arms, doesn't
she? Got Tyrannosaurus
arms. Nah, man. I'm talking about
her fingers are like little T squares.
Yeah, her little rubbery fingers. If you hold them up,
boomerang fingers.
His any nervous system conditions.
Yeah, yeah.
That's the only thing I'm talking
nervous
about.
Nervous system conditions are bad.
And on girls too.
Shaking.
I wanted to have sex with girls more because they had like what you mean like I don't know what you call it, like swivel hip. You know what I'm talking about? Or like elbow crutches and like a your hip kind of wiggles.
Like that weird kind of. Where the braces?
Yeah, I
those
really
not
have,
full crutches. The metal braces.
I wanted to bang somebody extra because of that. I have just felt
really
that.
Just
yeah.
like this.
And what stopped
sexual...
you? Didn't go up to her and say hi?
Yeah, she would
no,
just.
No, I didn't. I was...
She'd be into it.
Fucking.
She'd be cool with that.
Self esteem was low. Fucking asshole.
I got that one hip. I remember girls in school like.
I don't want to cheat on my girlfriend with a handicap check.
And then she snitches on you.
Well, honey, she had swivel hip. It's not cheating.
Like when I was going to like elementary school and shit like. like that. Yeah. It was fucking years ago. So you would get like the tail end of the thalidomide babies that you get.
Oh.
So they were like the ones with the weird displaced hips and fucking big water heads. And,
dude, I remember teachers from the end of the polio, you know, like the last guys that didn't get polio vaccine back in the day. Years ago when I was a kid.
The big shoe motherfuckers.
Yeah, big shoe people.
Big shoe people. You big shoe motherfuckers.
You know how lucky you are not to be alive back when you just get big shoe disease.
Jesus,
for
big shoe disease.
Jesus,
they didn't have a fucking shot for that.
And they had to explain it to us, like, well, he had polio and they didn't have a cure for it when you were... when he was in kindergarten.
Fucking, it was one of those diseases they hadn't cured yet. The fuck?
Baby foot.
Older weight.
Dude, how do people, by the way, ever take, like, a religion side over a science thing? It was just, like, all the shit you get from science and then nothing you get.
From religion.
Like, Bigfoot disease, who, that's gone because of science shit.
Right.
And, like, not one, I can't think of one religious thing that has helped anything.
Not one prayer has made Bigfoot disease go away.
No.
It was a shot that was invented by people that, yeah. Yeah, church just gives you this fucking hope, this false hope. That's science. Science! There weren't dinosaurs, and it was millions of years ago, not 5,000 years ago.
I hold my hair in. I got a nice head of science hair.
Science from, hair. Yeah, that's it. I prayed to God all I wanted. I had to go from Tinker for $12,000.
Yeah, dude, free of Propecia and Rogaine. I take both.
Does it work?
Yeah.
Damn.
With my hair, I would
go bald. Work. It's like it's not exciting.
Ah, dude, I would lose my hair in like a and not like unevenly, dude, up one side of my head.
Oh wow, really?
Like just horrific or
the big part.
But all that's left is this.
Did it grow back?
This awful peninsula that's up there, like it's just
peninsula.
I'm fine with it too, and I'm desperate to hold on to it. I don't even care.
It looks flammable.
Yeah, you just it's hold on.
He told me when I met him that my hair looks like burnt matches. That's the first thing he told me. You put some product in your hair because it looks like burnt matches.
Burnt matches.
He's so
I said somebody trying to cover up a fart.
And Patrice goes, "You were intimidated by me." Yes, this is all examples.
It was all. I have to tell people if I don't. Don't fucking play around with you. I don't like you.
Yeah, exactly.
That's what they have to all learn.
Then that's
what they
that's
learn.
All good.
At the end of the day.